Lana Del Rey decided to announce her new album by releasing a note and putting it on Instagram.
On a conditional form.
As celebrities are wont to do. And I think it's fair for me to read this quickly, but like thoroughly as best I can, to see why people interpreted it the way they did. And we'll talk about how that was interpreted, and we'll talk about Lana Del Rey more broadly. So the Instagram note reads, "Question for the culture. Now that Doja Cat, Ariana, Camila, Cardi B, Kalani, and Nicki Minaj and Beyonce have had number ones with songs about being sexy, wearing no clothes, fucking, cheating, etc., can I please go back to singing about being an embodied, female, feeling beautiful by being in love, even if the relationship is not perfect, or dancing for money or whatever I want without being crucified or saying that I'm glamorizing abuse? Many question marks. I'm fed up with female writers and alt singers saying that I glamorize abuse when in reality I'm just glamorizing a person singing about the realities of what we're all seeing are very prevalent emotionally." Sentence structure for the win. "Abusive relationships all over the world. With all the topics women are finally allowed to explore, I just want to say over the last 10 years, I think it's pathetic that my minor lyrical exploration detailing my sometimes submissive or passive roles in relationships has often made people say I've set women back hundreds of years. Let me be clear, I am not a feminist, but there has been to be a kind of place in feminism for women who look and act like me. The kind of woman who says, no but men hear yes. The kind of women who are slated mercilessly for being their authentic, delicate selves. The kind of women who get their own stories and voices taken away from them by stronger women or men who hate women." It's more just like her in that vein. She says, "I'll be detailing some of my feelings in my next two books of poetry, mostly the second one with Simon and Schuster." She's donating some of the proceeds to Native American foundations of her choice, and she has a new album coming out September 5th. So there's a lot to unpack there. Lord, mainly the first part, saying it's kind of like comparing her to artists that are having mainstream success right now, and they often speak about their relationships in their music.
Yeah, exactly.
And they have success with that. So she's wondering why, Lana Del Rey is wondering, why isn't there a place for her, Lana Del Rey, like extremely successful artist who like,
Norman fucking Rockwell got so much praise for an album. Like, we both didn't really like it. We thought it was cliche.
I mean, I thought it was one of her better albums.
It was definitely one of her better albums. I still think it's cliche. I think it's super cliche. And then she's trying to rep cities that she doesn't know about anything, but I'm going to end that warpath.
But anyways, a different thing.
But she got so much critical praise about that album all the time. Yeah. So I don't know what she's on about.
Well, the main part of it that I think is a thing to laser focus on, other than who she name dropped and all that stuff, is she says, "I'm fed up with female writers and alt singers saying that I glamorize abuse when in reality I'm just a glamorous person singing about the realities of what we're all seeing now."
I'm a glamorous person.
There's a lot of embellishment to that, but there's another part that says, "I think it's pathetic that my minor lyrical exploration detailing my sometimes submissive or passive roles in my relationships has often made people say I've set women back hundreds of years." This is a thing. It's like a cognitive distortion that social media has that I know is amplified, that you, it's amplified for you if you're a musician or a celebrity or someone in the public space, but, saying that your lyrics have set feminism back hundreds of years, you have to like actually sit down and think that. You can't in the first part say that you're not among some of the artists who are mentioned, which by the way, just to touch on that for a really quick moment, like many of those artists have songs that are about all of the debauchery that Lana is kind of
Cardi
going
B,
against.
Beat this pussy up, take it like a champ.
But there's also like Be Careful, and there's songs in Cardi B's repertoire that are very like deep and about getting your feelings hurt and stuff like that. There's definitely that with Ariana Grande. There's definitely that with Kalani. We just talked about that moments ago. To say that about Beyonce,
Beyonce
wasn't always like the yes queen, we like love her. She had to like, there was Charlie's Angels, there was like building her own name for herself. And so like there's a lot of stuff in there. There's Lemonade, like, part of this is like the thing Post Malone did last year, a couple years ago, where he said, "Oh, there's no rap music that makes me cry." It's just like, you're not looking hard enough.
It's like, dude,
especially weird for someone who considers themselves to be a contemporary of these artists that you're just like not looking that hard.
Yeah.
But the main part where, to get back to what I was saying, is like the main part where you're saying, often made people say, I've set women back hundreds of years, just go offline. Just go offline. Because to if you're actually going to take that criticism to heart, that one artist among many artists is single-handedly, with their own musical expression, which every artist does, setting back the idea of feminism hundreds of years, or any sort of like thing like that where it actually means like it matters, or like to say that your music is single-handedly pushing feminism in any sort of direction, is it's either Lana Del Rey overblowing the criticism, mm-hmm. or Lana Del Rey is very much in her own head about herself. And it's probably a little bit of both.
But because think of that statement for a second. Going back hundreds of years of feminism, then how on God's green earth, God's flat green earth, is your music sending women back to not being able to vote?
Yeah.
Like, or women not being allowed to drive unless you're in Saudi Arabia. Let's not talk about that. Or women not being allowed to...
Being able to drive on weekends. It's like getting gas in the 70s. It's like, depends on how you're...
Getting gas in the 70s is real rough. So stuff like that. Like, that's such a poor statement.
It's really short-sighted when Lana Del Rey demands a certain amount of respect for this statement, which she got a lot of credit for, because like it's just very, very ignorant. And the line where she's like, let's this be clear, I'm not a feminist, but...
It's not that's like saying, I'm not a racist, but Indians.
Like, she is constantly trying to say that she is making these feminine statements,
yes.
but she's very clearly saying, but I'm not a feminist. And I think like to say that is to accept this very like right-wing, like 4chan male idea of what a feminist is, which is like an overblowing, mm-hmm. like tiny percentage of people who are feminists, when if she like read like literally one or two books on feminism, like one or two of the more prominent ones, it would be like, it's just, it is, yes, a lot of what Lana Del Rey is saying. You express yourself however it is. And mm-hmm. Lana Del Rey should be allowed to make whatever art she's making and express it in the way she does and put it on her albums. She can kind of do that because she has fuck you money. Like, she's done really well and she can continue
also,
to do really well.
Also, maybe it's because those female artists are way better than you.
Yeah.
Like, they are hands down way better than just like describing their feelings, putting it out into the production of their music, making their music more available to people, and just making it objectively better.
Yeah. I think it's in touch with a broader audience as well.
For sure, 100%. You can give the criticism stuff all you want, which we obviously do. We talked about Kalani, where we said, this is now such a saturated market to where there are artists that are doing way better within this little realm of talking about feelings and relationships and stuff, to where your album itself didn't even feel like great, but it's still going to be better than what Lana has done because it's a little bit more approachable and stuff into it. You can relate to it a little bit more in that regard.
Yeah. She doubled down by saying that the media is misunderstanding what she's saying, which is not a great place to start by saying. You at best worded things really badly, and at worst are just like super full of yourself in your own head. Just chill. But no, she just like tried to over apologize for it. And this one part that I thought was funny is that this just caused a bunch of fandoms to fight, and Doja Cat wasn't having the best of weekends. We'll talk about that later in a moment. But a lot of the fandoms were going against Lana Del Rey's fandom, and like Lana Del Rey's fandom are like, this is dicey territory, but like Lana Del Rey's fandom are like upper middle class sad girls, and like Cardi B's fandom and Nicki Minaj fandom is like part of Black Twitter,
and like they will whip out their claws and fuck you up
digitally. And there's literally one comment on there. From a Lana Del Rey fan that says, a comment was on the Instagram post, Lana Del Rey said, from a Lana Del Rey fan, it said, please delete this, we're not a big fandom, we're all depressed and we cannot fight the barbs, please.
And that is a great attribution to your music, that it's not good. It's not as good as theirs, so... We report you decide.
That's Audioface. 3 years and running. Okay,